will be straightforward. Alhamdulillah, it doesn't happen with our brothers that were born and raised in here. It doesn't happen with them. Because they already know. But it happened with those who came from the outsiders. You will literally hear them sometimes say curse words when they speak. And this is the reason being in that environment where people you hear day in, day out, curse words. Something fall on the table, curse word. Something is nice, curse word. Something is sad, curse word. Something is pleasant, curse word. Something is unpleasant, curse word. Ila mata, until when? Everything is about curse word. So when we are in this environment and the likes of this, we got to really, barakallahu feekum, look at our stand in regard to that. Alhamdulillah, you can curse all you want, but I'm not going to allow you to do it in front of me. You don't got to talk to me. It doesn't matter who it is, though. Even if he's somebody that you work under, they got to respect you. Tell them straight up, listen, you might be doing this with the other guys, but with me, this is against my religion. And this is against my morale, my morality, my humanity. And they will respect it, barakallahu fiqh. So let us be mindful, barakallahu fiqh, of those words that even, and subhanAllah, what is amazing is, we don't even know the meanings when we say it. When some of the foreigners, when they use certain words, ask him what is the meaning of that, they don't know. No, seriously, taban. He don't know what is the meaning of that. He hear people, سَمِعْتُ النَّاسِ يَقُولُونَ فَقُلْتُ. I heard the people saying it, I'm saying it. Ask him, what does this mean? I'm telling you, 9 out of 10, they don't know. نَسَلُ اللَّهَ السَّلَامَ وَالْعَافِيَةِ. We, alhamdulillah, the Salafi, he control his tongue. He's not loose with it, alhamdulillah. If he doesn't say good things with it, he will refrain from saying things that can cause him. May Allah forgive us and guide us to what is right. Amen. So the Shahafidahullahu wa'ra'ah, he mentioned Al-Khannas, the brothers mentioned earlier, reminding us, the statement of Shaykh Salih Fawzan, Hafidahullah, Al-Khannas is the one yatakhallaf, the one that depart, tayyib, wa yabta'id, and he move away, tayyib. Yes, he withdraws. Very good. That's the term, barakallah. He withdraws. Jazakallahu khairan. So he is, fahuwa, this in the khannas, he is the one that he will whisper to you when you are heedless of the remembrance of Allah. Tayyib. But when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he run away. He depart. He stays away. He fall back, as we say. So therefore, he will only whisper to you ma'a al-ghafla. He only will whisper to you when you are heedless about remembering Allah. When you are heedless about mentioning the name of Allah, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentioned, that remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to be done by two things. By the tongue and by the heart. By the tongue and by the heart. Remembering Allah is to be done by the tongue and by the heart. Not just barakallahu fikum by the tongue. Tayyib. Not just by the tongue, by the tongue, but with the tongue along with the presence of the heart. Yani to be thinking about the meaning of what we say. Tayyib. In remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qala Allah ta'ala alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas min al-jinnati wan nas. Important lesson here. The Shahafidahu Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he mentioned the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which are the last verses. Alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas. Those who whisper fi sudurin nas. In the hearts of the people. Min al jinnati wa nas. From those who are of the mankind, from the jinn kind and the mankind. From those who are of the mankind and the jinn kind. Tayyib. Those who whisper into the hearts of mankind, from those who are of the jinn kind and the mankind. And these one are called the thaqalaini. Al-thaqalaini. Tayyib. When we hear the term al-thaqalaini, it means the jinn and the and the mankind. Jinn kind and mankind. That's how I call الثقلين. الثقلين. When we hear the term الثقلين, it means the and mankind. أحسنتم. The Shafidah Allah, he say, كأن معنا والله أعلم, as though the meaning of this word, الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس, he say, as that the meaning could be, and the Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah, he say, Allah knows best. He say, أن هناك موسوسين من الجن والإنس يوسوسون للناس. He say, the apparent meaning of the verse is that you have those among the mankind and those among the jinn kind that will be whispering to the human being. That will be whispering to the human being. He say, يأتون الناس, they will come to the person. He say, ويشكونهم ويشككونهم, and they will barakah, they will come to the people, they will whisper to them, and likewise barakallah, they will cause doubts, shak, they will cause doubts in their hearts, they will cause doubts in their hearts, and they will whisper to them and cause doubts in their hearts. He say, فكما أن للجن شياطين يوسوسون فكذلك للإنس شياطين يوسوسون. He say, likewise, the same way you have evil from the jinn, طيب, those who they whisper, likewise you have evil from the mankind that whisper also. So therefore, فأنت, or as you concern, he say, تستعذ بالله من شر القبيلتين. So as far as you are seeking refuge in Allah from these two tribes, the tribes of the mankind and the tribes of the jinn kind. ولهذا, and this is something that barakallahu fikum, that if we were doing it, we got to keep being very, I need knee on it. If we were doing it, we got to barakallahu fikum, adhere more into doing this. What the Shaykh rahimahullah, hafidhahullah, is about to say. He say, وَلِهَذَا يَقُولُ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. This is why the Messenger صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ said. He say, مَا تَعَوَّذَ. He say, there is no one that has sought refuge with these, meaning in these two surah, there is none that has seek refuge better than in these two surahs. Meaning, if a person read these two surah, there is no better refuge. Seeking refuge in these, barakallahu fi, by way of these two surah, that you cannot have better than that, in other words. So therefore, look at these two surah. That there is no, we would say ghaliban. Let's have the good thoughts for all the Muslims. We will say all the Muslims memorize these two surah. We will have good thoughts about the Muslims. We say all the Muslims, they memorize these two surah. You cannot seek protection better than with these two surah. You cannot seek protection better than these two surah. That's why the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned, he say, ما تعوذ, he say that there is none. He say no one seeking refuge has sought refuge, he say, by means of the likes of these two, better than the likes of these two. So therefore, this is something that we should never undermine. These two surah, we should never, barakallah, see it as, you know, we got it on the tip of our tongue. So it's something that is almost like no meaning, right? These are surah that everybody memorize. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did not put these two surah to be, barakallahu fikum, the whole surah al-Baqarah or the whole surah to Ali Imran. If he was to put that which barakallahu fikum is seeking refuge, the best seeking refuge, alaykum salam, to be placed in memorizing surah al-Baqarah, then you will remember, you will realize that maybe 90% of the Muslims will not be upon what? Seeking protection with this. So that's why he mentioned, أَيِّ هَاتَيْنِ سُورَتَيْنِ, meaning these two surah, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ and قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. قل أعوذ برب الفلق، قل أعوذ برب الناس. None seeking refuge has sought refuge by mean of the likes of these two that are better than them. Allahu Akbar. Which one? Where is it? The Shafi'i, Allah Ta'ala, he said, أخرجه أبو داود والنسائي وأحمد من حديث عقبة ابن عامر. طيب. أخرجه إمام أبو داود رحمه الله والنسائي رحمه الله إمام أحمد ابن حنبل رحمه الله من حديث عقبة ابن عامر رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he mentioned, فَيَنْبَغِي لِلْمُسْلِمِ. So now it is incumbent upon the Muslim أَنْ يَقْرَأَهُمَا فِي أَدْبَارِ الصَّلَوَاتِ وَيُكَرِّرُهُمَا وَيَقْرَأُهُمَا عِنْدَ النَّوْمِ مَعَ آيَةِ الْكُرْسِي وَسُورَةِ الْإِخْلَاسِ. Allahu Akbar. He said, then it is incumbent upon the Muslim to be repeating these two surah after the salah. To be repeating, to recite these two surah after the salah, and to keep repeating them. And to recite it every night, along with Ayatul Kursi and Suratul Ikhlas. So we should not, barakallahu fikum, sleep on these two, on this surah. Suratul Ikhlas, Suratul Falaq, Suratul Nas, and Ayatul Kursi. These, barakallahu fikum, are verses, walhamdulillah, along with the other benefits, that they are ayat that the believer will recite to seek protection in Allah subhanahu, to seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of the shayateen, from the jinn, and the shayateen of the human being. The Shahafidahullah ta'ala, he say, Yaqra ayatul kursi, he say, the believer, he reads ayatul kursi, wa suratul ikhlas, wal mu'awwidhatayni. He will read ayatul kursi, he will read qul suratul ikhlas, qul huwa Allahu ahad, and he will read al mu'awwidhatayni. And Al-Mu'awwidhatayni was the name that Jibreel gave to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was being put a spell by the Yahudi lady by way of the hair. Right? By the way of the hair that they place in the well. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned a very important issue. He said, as far as the hair, it is not to be buried. As far as the hair, it is not to be buried. Some people, after they shave their head, not the lihya is haram. As when they finish shaving the head, they will dig and they will bury it under the ground. Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he say, Hada la yuf'al. This is not to be done. And we see many people doing that. So with the same concept of burying it, shuf, they don't have where to bury it here maybe. They will flush it. That's the same concept. They want to qiyas. They want to transfer it. If I can do this, let me see what could take like burying. Because flushing could take, Yes, the aql, right? So the hair, barakallahu fikum, it is not to be buried. If you thinking that, okay, you got to flush it, hakadha barakallahu fikum aidan. It is not to be done. But rather to be, mashallah, to be dispensed onto in the trash can. Of course, walhamdulillah, anything we put in the trash can, we say bismillah. Tayyib. And going to the dumpster also, we say bismillah. As our beloved brother reminded us the other day of when we put to the dumpster, we say bismillah. In case that you will harm a jinn. And you're not doing it purposely. Because the dumpster and the likes of those filthy areas, that's there.